So, I've been filling in gaps of places I'd explored because when I first started poking around, I had been avoiding alien ruins specifically, because I had, at that point, been waiting until I had telekinesis, which was a waste of time, not just because telekinesis doesn't fucking work, but also because it left holes in places that looked like I had already explored them. But there was also some not quite complete exploration anyway. So I just decided to start from the bottom and work my way up. I started on this side and have gotten up to essentially here. So I'm trying to do basically the same on this side. I'm here. And I did do a loop around here just to make sure there wasn't anything else there. I have gone up along up to seeing this in the distance to, you know, basically have the bottom of this. The goal was basically to get the rest of this. There are a couple of things I can see from here that aren't too far, but I'm trying to have visually distinct places on the map that I can go. I have explored up to there. And this level's about, well, it is half done. Both in that I have 5 points towards will and 5 points towards the level. Mostly haven't been collecting alchemy components because it's that container's gotten sluggish already, and it's not like I have made anything in a while. So since they're a waste of arrows, and it's, the thing I'm trying to finish off anyway, I've also, started doing that. Fireballing the squishy things that you could one-shot with basically anything, so why waste arrows on them? It is weird to leave things behind. It feels weird, it looks weird. Top off my arrows when I was also dropping stuff off. Because even if I'm not actively accumulating them, I do still accumulate things that need to be dropped off, Welkin Stone. Well, even though I'm not actively harvesting these, I do still find alchemy components. And I still find other things like Welkin Stones that... Nope. I'm not even gonna bother. I will get to a point where I'll just throw it on the ground, so... I still pick it all up if it's in a container. Though I also should, when I eventually decide to actively poke through what I've got and see what even does what, because... For a lot of things, I don't know. So I don't even know what I should be wanting to collect, because there are things, just like with the enchantments, there are things that you can do better with a potion than you can reasonably do with a spell. Especially if you have maxed out alchemy. Alchemy equipment. So, there is a functional difference internally, if not clear externally, between choosing to hit something more than once because I can and they're not troublesome, and having to. Like, I have to hit them more than once, stealthing. Them I can one shot. There's always that balance between, do I really want to waste arrows versus if I'm hitting fewer things and getting less training done. Hitting things less. I'm not hitting fewer things, but I'm having fewer hits. Same number of things. The number of hits is lower. So the amount of training is lower. A lot more arrows. Not that it's any surprise that an ogre turns out to be a sturdier thing with more hit points, and my attacks only cut through whatever thick hide bonus they have to their armor if they don't see me. Bonus, the perk that comes with the master stealth is sneak attacks, ignore armor. So it's more than just the 3x multiplier for most things, because cutting through armor adds up. That is everything here. Probably cut this way, because that's something I haven't done. To see if there's anything there. Thank you. Okay. Bunch of things over there. And my acrobatics is definitely at the point where unfortified with boots. It's higher than it would normally be fortified for that quest. But I... Okay, you are full. But I am still... gonna max it out first. Glow. Those are pretty low on the list of things to hold on to. eventually get to all of it. As we do. Nothing else there, so yeah, that's how we got up there. Since I didn't look around before engaging with that floor panel. I won't know what it does. Was that not open before? Get out of the way. first. It's one of the weird things about those is you'll see the arrows flying on the ground, and you can collect them before you loot the body. But once you loot the body, which of course you never find them on, they disappear. Which is different from the ones they actually bounce off of. Like if I shoot a skeleton or a frost atronach and loot it, their bodies first, the arrows do actually bounce off and I can pick them up again after looting. But because these are kind of sort of weirdly stuck in, I don't get that. Both, I don't get my arrows, but I also don't get why that's Bethesda. Weird, stupid, nonsensical mechanics thing. It's just Bethesda. I can't imagine. You know. Reasonable person thought that that should happen, was a good idea. Mark that down. Now my will is one behind. And that one needs to not be the trailing one. Because unlike Morrowind, you have to get the credit for step training done before you hit that level mark. Everything that happens after doesn't count. They made leveling so much more obnoxious than it was in the previous game. And then they simplest shorthand for what I think they did, generally speaking, with Skyrim was oversimplify it to try and appeal to a broader audience while alienating some of their base in the process. sections. They're not all locked cells in this one. Just gonna push me over faster. How the fuck did an area of effect manage to miss you? Thank you. behind a thing. Well. That wore off. Okay. That's not what I wanted. Just say no to liches. That statement applies to way more games than just this one. I mean, liches get stitches is far too forgiving. Most other undead are more forgivable than liches, because it's not a self-inflicted wound on most other undead. The fuckers did that shit to themselves, though. So... charming. Close-ish. You are not. Ratio on that is less bad than with other things that I mentioned that before. Worse though. actually use these and be fine. But I'm not gonna. It's not entirely consistent when wraiths and gloom wraiths do or don't carry things. It's not always one or the other. So it's kind of hard to tell unless I need to hit it more than once which one I'm dealing with. If I have to hit it more than once, it was a gloom wraith. I had originally thought, because that was just how I had been encountering them, that it was entirely gloom wraiths that had the swords, and regular wraiths that didn't. Oh, this room. And then, or variant of this room, and another one. Once you go through enough of them, you find, distinct patterns and how they construct things. Way to help me do my job. It's not worth looking around, but it's an interesting find. Oh, right. This one has more elaborate, step construction. Mostly seen that grand stairway directly connected to the other grand stairway type thing. Nope. Oh. Should probably ditch you just because you're heavy. But... that category is next. I'm not gonna take your shitty arrows. Or your profoundly shitty. Seems to be everything. Boom! Okay, it's been an hour. So I will cut things here and pick up wherever it is I am tomorrow when I get around time to needing to record.